So I'm here with the Conservative Councillor for the Wych Ward, Robert Nemeth. We're here to talk a bit about, well, some city issues, really, including, I know there's an issue with field officers in the inner city, but also Madeira Drive reopening and a city plan too. We'll start off with the field officers. What's the particular issue here?
So the field officer issue was uncovered by my colleague, Councillor Nick Lurie, who's one of the Hangleton and Knoll councillors. Yeah. And he was essentially saying why in his ward is so much antisocial behaviour going unchecked by the council. And there's this could be in council housing or normal housing. And it manifests itself in many ways, from dirty front gardens to noise to just litter, that sort of stuff. You know, lack of maintenance on a property. And he uncovered at a full council meeting that around half of the field officers haven't been employed, which is fairly scandalous. And they weren't working during the COVID period either. So what that's meant is a flagship policy of the Labour administration has been an absolute failure. And it's very sad, because if you ask most people what their problem is with the council, it's about the state of the city.
Yeah.
You know, which again manifests itself in many different ways. But it's this idea that Brighton and Hove is looking run down. It's just not working. It's not its usual attractive self.
Yeah.
And the field officer position was designed to tackle that head on.
And to kind of liaise with members of the public that have issued complaints.
Yeah, very much so. Other posts were removed so that this whole field officer team could be put in place as this sort of crack squad of individuals to tackle this kind of thing.
Yeah, and how many field officers are there meant to be then? Do we know that?
Well, there's meant to be...
complement?
Yeah, there's meant to be 7 full-time roles, which could mean, you know, up to 14, I guess.
Yeah. Yeah. OK. And then what about the future role of filling those posts then? Do we know what the council's saying?
Well, the number who are employed has actually fallen since the Green administration took over. So it's, yeah. I mean, so it's essentially a disaster at the moment. So who knows? But the main issue is, well, there's 2 issues really: state of the city, and their funding. So council house tenants are being charged for these field officers, and they're not getting the service. So council rent goes towards their employment.
Yeah.
You know, it's one of the reasons why the whole position was created, and council tenants haven't had the service that they paid for.
Okay, so what can be done then? So obviously we've had the coronavirus outbreak, so I'm guessing that could be a reason for the delay in filling those posts. That's probably what the council would say. I mean,
it's exactly what the council would say. But did you notice any delay when the council needed to rustle up people to man either end of Madeira Drive in stopping motorists coming onto Madeira Drive? Or did you notice any delay in filling posts when the council suddenly needed to bring in safety measures at Hove Tip when the unsafe cycle lanes on the Old Shoreham Road were put in place with just a moment's notice?
Yeah, OK. So Madeira Drive reopening, pretty good news, isn't it, really? I mean, traffic going one way towards Duke's Mound, cyclists having a wider space in which to cycle, pedestrians seem to be pretty happy too. They're going to have the same space that they had before.
Yep, so this is a huge victory for common sense, which is what Conservatives locally specialise in. This is a proposal that was drawn up by my colleague, Councillor Lee Wares, Patcham councillor, and he's the he's our spokesman on transport. And so it was fairly scandalous the way that Madeira Drive was suddenly closed to vehicles. Many disabled groups had huge complaints about this issue. So Lee submitted a proposal where the northern carriageway of Madeira Drive would be open to traffic, especially coming off the Palace Pier roundabout. Yeah. And then there's enough space for the southern side to be, you know, cycling, running, and then, you know, walking, etc.
Yeah.
And it's a very common sense solution that works for nearly everybody, in particular the traders who were sold down the river by the council once again.
Yeah, exactly. Moving on to City Plan 2 then, I know there's been some issues around people living on the urban fringe. I know that in the City Plan, a lot of urban fringe areas are earmarked for future development for housing. Is there any particular areas that are coming up on your radar that are residents are concerned about?
Well, the biggest message is for residents to reply to the consultation on City Plan Part 2. So just Google Brighton and Hove City Plan Part 2 consultation, and you have the opportunity to to give your views.
Until the end of October, I think.
Yeah, I mean, there's many controversial sites in there, but the worst really is the urban fringe, which is the last remaining natural outer areas of Brighton and Hove within the bypass. Coldean springs to mind as an example. Portslade, Patcham, Whitehawk Hill, and at the top of Whitehawk Hill on the top road there. These sites, and there are a few others, I think there's one in Ovingdean, which is not popular. They only account for a tiny amount of the housing allocation, so 930 homes of 16,000.
Yeah.
And Conservatives are saying just remove these precious natural areas, and of course Labour and the Greens are trying to build on them.
Yeah.
Despite saying many times that they're trying to save them.
Yeah.
And in council, you either vote, for or against. You don't have this option of, I'm passionate about them, but I'm still not going to support them. And this is the issue. Labour are talking all the time as though they wish to save, the natural areas of Whitehawk Hill. That's what they're telling residents. And then they come and vote to build on it. And, it's something that people need to be aware of, because this is how the council
actually works. And I know we're going to be talking about that in more detail as well before the end of October. So thanks for coming today, Robert. All the best. Thanks.
Thanks, Mark. Cheers.